years. When information's in its place, I'm in a massive guessing game. Guess what? I don't like guessing games, or when I feel things before I know the feelings. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast, or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close, or call the waiter by his first name or eat Oreos, but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most, what scares me the most, is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can't hide from it? What happens then if when he knows me, he's only disappointed? What if I give myself away to only get it given back? I couldn't live with that. So I'm just fine. Inside my shell, shape mine this way, I get the best view. So that when he sees me, I want him to. I'm not defensive, I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating why. A certain suitor stands in line. I've seen the movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable life. He could be criminal, some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind. Or even worse, he could be very nice above the eyes and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What do I do with that? Oh God, what if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? What happens then if when he holds me, my heart is set in motion? I'm not prepared for that, I'm scared of breaking open. But still I get help from hoping I'll find someone to talk to who likes the way I am. Someone who when he sees me wants to
spotlight man, turn off my light, 'cause the show is done now, and it's time to leave the stage. Yeah, the good guy won now, and the band has no more songs to play. It's a happy ending, so I'll say goodbye. Goodbye to all the make-believe. Goodbye. There's no more magic up my sleeves. There's nothing left to act up here. I'll take my bow and disappear. No questions left for answering. The word that's music to my ears is goodbye. It's a happy ending. no one earth. Now the curtain's descending, and I hope you got your money's worth. Gonna stop the show now, 'cause I wanna leave on top. So get up and go now, 'cause there's nothing left inside my head. Everything that's left to say's been said. But goodbye, goodbye to all the song and dance. Goodbye, off stage I stand a better chance. The show is through, the parts have been played. No standing in, no wings afraid. No violins or phony tears. Word that's music to my ears is goodbye. Now goodbye. 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 I'm not afraid of stopping. This end could be my start. I want to live a life and not just play a part. I'll walk into the sunset, I'll sail across the sea. The final word, the last you'll hear of me, of me, is goodbye. Goodbye to every night alone. Goodbye. Goodbye to lives that I don't own. I'm tired of living on the stage, a life that's only on the page. Empty lives are in the past. I've tried before, but here's the last. Goodbye. Now goodbye. Goodbye.
Princess Annalise, what is a royal like yourself doing in such a poor provincial town?
I'm savoring my first and last taste of freedom before getting married next week to a total stranger.
Well, at least you're not an indentured servant.
Indentured servant?
If I like to have my breakfast hot, then the cart will make me pay. And I have to fetch the eggs myself in the barns on my way. It's cold and wet until I get an omelet on my plate. But in my head, I'm back in bed, tickled up and sleeping late.
Really?
Really. But that's all right, I mean, I'm used to it. And you?
Well, if I want some eggs, I ring the bell and the maid comes running in. And she serves them on a silver tray and she brings a cookie tin. And while I eat, she rubs my feet and strolling minstrels play. But I'd rather be in my library reading science books all day.
I'm just like you.
You are?
You're just like me. There's somewhere else we'd rather be. Somewhere that's ours, somewhere where dreams come true. Yes, I am a girl like you. You never think that it was so. When I've met you and I know, it's plain that day, sure as the sky is blue, that I am a girl like you.
So you're a singer?
No. I work in Madame Carp's penitentiary. I mean, dress emporium.
I love Madame Carp's dresses.
I made the one you're wearing.
You made this? The design looks so complicated.
Oh, but it isn't really. First I choose the fabric from the rack and I pin the pattern down. And I stitch it in the front and back and it turns into
a gown.
I wear my gown without my crown and dance around my room. And imagine life without the stripe of an unfamiliar groom.
But I'd never let my mother know. I wouldn't want to disappoint her.
I completely understand.
I'm just like you.
I think that's true.
You're just like me.
Yes, I can see
We take responsibility.
We carry through to what we need to do.
Yes, I am a girl like you.
I'm just like you.
I'm just like you.
You're just like me.
You're just like me.
It's something anyone can see.
A heart that beats.
A heart that beats.
A voice that speaks the truth. Yes, I am a girl like you.
Up the skies to open a world and send a reeling, a voice that says I'll be here and you'll be alright. I don't care if I know just where I would go, 'cause all that I need is this crazy feeling, a rat-tat-tat on my arms. Think I wanted to stay. City of stars, are you shining just for me? City of stars, never shine so brightly.
There's a breeze off the river, through the crack in the window pane. There's my boy on the pillow, and I feel like I'm lost again. Everybody knows the secret, they all know what their life should be, and they move like a river. Everybody knows except for me, and I never feel like somebody. Somebody calls a father, I can't explain, but when I look at your kid, it's like a mirror. It spins my head, it wakes me, like the breeze off the river. Every time I see your face, and it's strange but familiar, like a map of a better place. And sometimes I feel like I live in a shadow. Shadows all I see. Then you jump straight up and you grab the moon and you make it shine on me. Where do you get it from? Everybody knows the secret. Well, I don't, and I never did. I don't know any secret. All I know is I love you, kid. All I know is I love you, kid. All I know.
Forgiven, baby, come out, get dressed. You're my date to the pep rally tonight. You chucked me out like I was trash for that. You should be dead. But then it hit me like a flash. What if high school went away instead? Those people are the key. They're keeping you away from me. They made you blind, messed up your mind, but I can set you free. You left me and I fell apart. I punched the wall and cried bam, bam, bam. Then I found you changed my heart and set loose all that truthful stuff inside. And so I built a plan. Tonight our school will take a stand. Let's guarantee they cannot finish to the end. I was meant to be yours. We were meant to be one. Don't up on me now. Finish what we've begun. I was meant to be yours. So when the students all get doomed, my God, I've lost my mind. In the rubble of their tomb, we'll plant this note explaining why they died. We destroyed students of Westerberg High will cry, our burned bodies may finally get through. To you, your society turns out slaves and blanks. No thanks, signed, students of Westerberg High. Goodbye. We'll watch the smoke pour out the doors. Bring marshmallows, we'll make s'mores. We can smile and cuddle while the fire roars. I was meant to be yours. We were meant to be one. I can't make it alone. Finish what we've begun. You were meant to be mine. I am all that you need. You carved open my heart. Can't just leave me to bleed. Veronica! Open the door, please. Veronica, open the door. Veronica, can we not fight anymore, please? Can we not fight anymore? Veronica, I'm sure you're scared. I've been there. I can set you free. Veronica, don't make me come in there. I'm gonna count to three. One, two, God! Veronica? Veronica. Please don't leave me alone. You were all I could trust. I can't do this alone. Still I will live by my.
Left your sweater thing? Is it in fashion? I don't know. Veronica?
My life is just despair.
he takes me in his arms. The world is bright, all bright. What's the difference if I say, there's no hope.
Hey, it's me.
Sounds like you all are having a good time. What do you say? We have a lot of great talent here at Edison, and I'm so proud of all these students. But there's a particular award that I am so proud of to recognize a couple of students, and this is the Edison Choral Award of Merit. The Edison Choral Award of Merit is a recognition given by the director to one student of each ensemble at our four main concert. This award recognizes the student whose contributions to their ensemble are felt because of their presence, positive spirit, integrity, and leadership. This award may not always go to the person whose contributions are musical, but to the ones who make their ensemble a better place for everyone around them. Undeniably, we know that our choirs would not be the same without them. I often think of this recognition as the Unsung Hero Award. Although these persons may not hear all the praise, they deserve all the credit. First, from our Intuition Vocal Ensemble, this is one of our mixed ensembles, the one that did Little Shop of Horrors today. They're the newest ensemble, which means that they have students, many of which are brand new to Edison for the first time. And that's no exception for this student that I'm recognizing today. She, throughout this entire year, has been a really steady person and someone you can rely on, but here, she started to blossom. She's one of our dance captains, and she is surely the backbone of the Intuition operation for dance. This is Sam Galindo. From Ingenuity, our treble vocal ensemble, there's a lot of competition because these students are very, very dedicated. They love what they do, especially this night on Broadway performance. This student I got to know for the first time this year, and along the way has really impressed me. And the farther we've gone along in the year and have gotten to know the student, I've seen how much they contribute, not just musically, but also to the positive space that we're in. She's a lot of fun. She's a great talent. She's also a little bit sassy. This is Karina Horvat. I've had the pleasure of knowing this singer from Innovation Vocal Ensemble for 2 years. I think this person is very steady, very dependable, and everyone gets along with the singer. The singer has a lot of talent and is always eager to jump in whenever this singer can, always hops in, is usually the first when I say, I need help with this, this singer just hops right in to do it. Not only that, he has a great voice and he makes this city full of stars. Stephen Maison. Give a round of applause for our Choral Award of Merit recipients. Well, thank you for joining us for this first half. We're going to be closing with a number today called I See Stars from the hit Mean Girls the Musical, based on Mean Girls the Movie, after which we'll be having a 15-minute intermission.
How I used to be. Here, take it. Now I'm awake. I'll tell you what I see. Plastic don't shine, glitter don't shine, rhinestones don't shine the way you do. You are so real, you are so rare. I see you there.
I see you. I see stars.
See, I went home not high. That was my problem.
We are so.
There are worse things I could do than go with a boy or two. Even though the neighborhood thinks I'm trashy and no good, I suppose it could be true. But there are worse things I could do. I could flirt with all the guys, smile at them, then bat my eyes, press against them when we dance, make them think they stand a chance, but refuse to see it through. That's a thing I never do. I could stay home every night.
A price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, would you hurl in the seas when you see me go by? Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back, soon you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da, ya da 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 da, ya da ya da 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 da, ya da ya da 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 da, ya da 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 da, ya da 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 da. You say a love is draining and you can't go on. I am gone. And no, don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet submissive subject, my loyal, royal subject. Oh,
forever and ever. Ever and ever and ever, you'll be lying before. I will fight the fight and win the war for your love, for your grace, and I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away the sting. 'Cause when comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
walk when I can run. I don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should kick back and chill, but I can't stand still. Called the doctor, he said, son, I cannot offer you a pill. So I never found relief, now I got a moving tail. I've had my fill, but I can't stand still. Back where I come from, life's never humdrum. I wish I could take you there. Oh, we have the world at our feet. Life is sweet, ain't no doubt. Grab a seat, ha! Check it out. Oh, I thought it never would end, but I lost it somehow. Would you look at me now? I'm trying not to tone it down. Gotta watch my P's and Q's. Maybe look before I leap, and then I think, hey, what's the use? Ain't done it yet, but I can't forget how it feels when you dance till you drop. So don't even start, so just try to stop. Oh, I never will. No, I can't stand still.
by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind of the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore.
One of the most bittersweet parts of this concert is knowing that we're saying goodbye to some people who've grown very close with us over these many years, and these, of course, are our seniors. One of the frequent questions I get around each concert from people who hear the choir is, how do the choirs get so good? My answer tends to vary depending on the performance, but I think there's a fundamental truth that I've neglected to share. The choirs are the way they are because they're stronger together. Individually, there's talent to be sure, but it is that strength in numbers that is what makes these choirs what they are. And when I think about strength in numbers, I immediately think about the class of 2024. What do I mean exactly? Well, simply put, the friendships within this class are tight. Dare I say, inseparable and sometimes unbreakable. In fact, as I look back on the memories with this class, I don't think I remember a time where I saw any one of them alone. As my mom would say, they're attached at the hip. And by the way, my mom's in the front row here tonight. This group of seniors is defined by their bonds. I think of these iron-forged friendships like Sam and Porter, Rowita, Kaylin, Elena, and Jade, Charlene and Liba, Kim and Adriana, JJ, Camden, Allison, even brand new Edison singers like Jonathan and Kennedy have found their way into the fold in their own individual way. And if you're an Edison singer out there right now, you're probably starting to think, hey, yeah, I don't think I've ever seen them apart either. Comical? Yes. But that is such a true testament to the deep loyalty, compassion, and connection these students have for each other. In fact, these friendships are so strong and they're so inseparable, I had a hard time knowing their individual personalities because I only knew them as the group. We were all shocked to hear Kaylin solo for the first time at Night on Broadway last year. I was cry laughing when I found out Rowita is one of the funniest people you've ever met. I've learned that Kim is the ultimate here for a good time, not a long time girl, but always there to bring you a smile when you need it most. There's Porter, who has an unwavering commitment to bring the best show every time, no matter what. I've gotten to know that Sam is endlessly brimming with compassion and empathy. Liba, who has a strong moral compass and always knows what's right and what's wrong. And Allison, who has no problem saying, "No, Mr. Lackey, you're wrong." Charlene is the least likely to speak out, but maybe the most important perspective to be heard. Camden is a sweetheart who will melt your soul. Jade, who is one of the calmest and strongest leaders I've met. Elena, who is known for her deep reliability and trustworthiness. I've learned Kennedy can really, really dance, and that Jonathan is just the world's nicest guy. How do you do that? JJ, who is always the first to find someone alone and make them feel welcome. And if there was a competition for talking, Adriana might seriously win, but only because she gets along with everybody. However their personalities and life interests may differ, none of that gets in the way of their strength and bond. As someone who admires loyalty and steadiness, I've come to find that individually and together, they are honest people through and through. To the choral singers of the class of 2024, never forget what made you who you are. Never forget the challenges you faced and overcame. As you go near and far, never forget the ones who pushed you, loved you, cherished you, and helped you define who you are. But please, from the bottom of a grateful choir director's heart, never forget the accomplishments you've achieved on this very stage. As you heard me say before we walked out for our first number, we are the lucky ones. We're the here and now. Forever, your time here can never be changed, and forever, you will always be a part of it. Like every singer before you and after you, your here and now has to pass. because in a few short moments, our time performing at Edison together will come to an end, and a new group of young singers will have their chance to be the lucky ones too. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you the choral singers from the class of 2024. We're gonna do this in classic Edison fashion. So, as I call it a name, we're gonna do a one clap, which means I'll say a name and we all go boom, all together. So we're gonna practice. Mr. Lackey. Yeah, so you're good at it. And seniors, as you come out, please take a stand across that line. Our first senior is Liba. She has been singing in chorus for 4 years. Her plans is that she's going to attend Virginia Tech and major in public health on a pre-med track. She hopes to go to med school and specialize in pediatric oncology. Her favorite choir memory is door-dashing Chipotle after our first night in Universal, staying up late and talking with her roommates about random things. Our next senior is JJ. JJ has been in choir for 4 years and is planning to go into Nova's radiology program in order to become a registered technologist in radiology. Her favorite choir memories are the discussions and conversations the choir would have that would take up a lot of the class time. Nice. Our next senior is Charlene Luong. Charlene has been in choir for 3 years. Next year, she is going to the University of Virginia and majoring in economics. Her favorite choir memories, plural, is the spring trip to Camp Horizons and the trip to Orlando Studios. Our next senior is Sam. Sam has been at Edison singing for 4 years. Next year, she's going to college at the University of Kansas to get a BA in human biology. Her favorite choir memory is sitting with Porter in a field at Camp Horizon and finding out that he got into governor school. What did I say? Our next senior is Jonathan Sanchez. This is his first year in choir. He is going to college for sports medicine or athletic training at Manchester University in Indiana or the University of North Carolina at Greensboro, to be determined. His favorite choir memory is gossiping with the sopranos and messing around with the baritones during after-school rehearsals. Classic. Our next senior is Kennedy Roberts. Kay has been in choir for 2 years, though this is their first year at Edison. Next year, they're going to Nova, currently undecided, but looking at arts program. And Kay's favorite memory was at her last school when the high school choir sang Dream On by Aerosmith as their closing song at their final concert. Allison Cameron. Allison has been in choir for 4 years. Next year is going to the University of Maine for chemical engineering. It's cold, just so you know that. Yeah. Her favorite choir memory is getting Froyo with Camden and JJ before concerts. Speaking of, our next senior is Camden. Camden has been in choir for 4 years. Next year, going to the Rochester Institute of Technology, majoring in game design and development. And Camden's favorite memory is hanging out in class on those days after concerts we didn't have anything to do. Our next senior is Adriana. Adriana has been in choir for 4 years, and next year is going to Nova to study nursing. Her favorite choir memory would probably be at assessments. It's one of the few times where the whole chorus is put together and connect with one another, and she enjoys when she can do events and songs all together as one. Another fun memory was this year's Universal trip. She loved being able to spend time with her friends outside of school and connecting closer to more of the chorus kids. She's 1,000% going to miss everybody, especially the new choir kids she's met this year. Our next senior is Jade. Jade has been in chorus for 4 years. Next year is going to Nova for business as a business major. Her favorite choir memory from choir was back in sophomore year when they went to Alexandria City High School for assessment. This day was when she met her favorite people, Emily, Noelia, Kaylin, Rowita, got really close. She's extremely fortunate and grateful that she had these great friends who she can also sing with whenever they decide to hang out. Kaylin Herrera. She has been in choir for 4 years. Next year is going to Nova, majoring in graphic design. She doesn't have a specific memory, but her favorite thing has been getting to know the people in choir and the friends that she has gained and have gotten closer to because of it. Elena! Elena has been in choir for 3 years. She's going to Nova for 2 years to study architectural technology and business, then will transfer. Her favorite memory has been able to be with her friends. Although she took a year off, coming back to choir, her friends were very welcoming and it felt like she had never left. Through choir, she was able to be more social and have stronger relationships with friends. Porter Burtman. Porter has been in choir for 4 years. Next year is going to West Virginia University to major in musical theater. His favorite choir memory was when he sang and a cappella the whole soundtrack of Pitch Perfect 1, 2, and 3 with Haley Short on the whole bus ride down to Florida. And his favorite song that he has ever sang was She Walks in Beauty with Innovation year 21-22. Rowita! Yeah! Rowita has been in choir for 4 years. Next year is attending Virginia Commonwealth University and studying dental hygiene. Her favorite choir memory, I was gonna make a joke about good hygiene, all right, whatever, good. My favorite choir memory is finding, her favorite choir memory is finding her friend group. It's been so special to see all of us grow together and change over the years. Watching her choir friends blossom into their own unique selves has been one of the most rewarding parts of her choir experience. Kimberly! Kim is planning on going to Nova to study sonography, that is, to be an ultrasound technician. Her favorite choir memory is meeting some of the sweetest people throughout these years. Ladies and gentlemen, the choir singers of the class of 2024. Time for them to sing their last song here at Edison, their senior song.
By the river, and it made me complete. We want to thank our principal, Mrs. Mandy Burke, and her administrative team, especially Miss Mary Beth Starkey, our fine arts administrator. These awesome people constantly support us, ensure that we have everything we need to make music, give us permission to miss school for choir events, and put music at the top of their priority list. Without them, we would not have the exceptional choir program that we do. Thank you, Mrs. Burke, Miss Starkey, and all the administrators for your endless support.
Hi, I'm Yuki Kalakassis, and I'm Ingenuity's class rep. And it would be impossible to deliver this fun and exciting program tonight without the true heroes of this performance, our tech team. This expert team is rarely heard from, but are the key to an incredible performance. We couldn't do this without you. Let's give them a big applause.
And I'm the choir librarian, and we would be lost without our most favorite person, Mrs. Allwine. We thank her all the time, and it still won't be enough for everything she gives to us. She's at every rehearsal, she gives extra help to anyone who asks, and when she laughs, we know we delivered our lines right. Let's give it up for Miss Allwine.
Hi, my name is Aisha Boyd, and I'm the choir historian. You met these wonderful people at the door concession stand. We want to take a moment to thank our Choral Guild Parents Support Organization. No music program can be successful without our parents giving more to make our experience at school something to remember. Mrs. Bergman, Mrs. Bird, and Mr. Boyd, we're so thankful that you support us and help nights like this one be so special. Thank you.
that's because we have the best choreographer ever. Miss Jessie choreographed every group number you saw tonight and came in numerous times throughout the year to help us prepare for this performance. She's an exceptionally talented, very kind, and another one of our favorite people. She works with many schools in our area, but we are proud to say that she is part of our Edison family. So please, Miss Jessie, come on stage. We want to gift you this year's choir t-shirt. Everyone, let's give her a